So this is the courthouse where the most high-profile criminal trial in China in recent memory will be taking place. We've been here for a few hours now, and so far, surprisingly, very little sign of visible security, and only some other reporters lingering around to location scout, just like what we are doing right now. And this is surprising because the authorities have been very sensitive about the whole case involving, of course, Gu Kailai, the wife of disgraced Communist Party leader Bo Xilai. Authorities haven't said this is a closed trial, so we're going up and try to see if we can apply to attend the court session tomorrow on Thursday.
不是，那我能不能，比如说我作为一个公众就进去，我了解一下怎么样申请旁听的？我不是要去采访啊。你这个身份证不允许带你，不好意思，身份证不允许带你，出来吧，好吧。
Well, again, seems like nobody knows anything other than that number that's constantly engaged, and they all claim this is the only way to get in, to even talk to somebody who knows anything about how to apply to attend a court session. So it seems we are out of luck. And actually, interestingly, one of the ladies at the front desk at the other gate told me, I know exactly which case you're interested in, but you're not going to see any information about that case anywhere here. So away from the rather isolated courthouse, we are here on one of Hefei's busiest shopping streets, trying to gauge the local population's knowledge on this very high-profile case in their normally low-key city. Now, before rain started falling, we were able to talk to some people on the streets from different age groups and backgrounds, asking them about Gu Kailai. Most of them seem to be either unaware or simply don't care about this trial at all. Finally, we got to this older gentleman who said he was following the news, and he said, I have lived long enough to realize how sensitive this case is. But right before he was ready to tell us what he meant, two policemen showed up out of nowhere trying to drag me, my cameraman, and that older gentleman away, saying we were conducting illegal interviews in public. When I pointed out to them, according to Chinese laws and regulations, foreign reporters are allowed to conduct interviews in public as long as we have the interviewee's consent. The police still wouldn't let us go. After much heated arguments back and forth, and with an increasingly bigger crowd gathering around us, finally, the policeman photographed my press ID and let me go. But as these fresh bruise marks on my arm can prove, this case of Gu Kailai's trial is definitely very, very sensitive here in China. Steven Jiang, CNN, Hefei.